Important trends and the anomalous behavior of carbon. See, carbon is the first member of the group. That is, the carbon also differs from rest of the member of its groups. Okay, because it is having a smaller size, high electronegativity, high ionization enthalpy, and unavailability of the d orbital. So usually the only s and p orbitals are available for the bonding, because the carbon atomic number is 6. So therefore it can accommodate only 4 pair of electron around it. Okay, so this would limit the maximum covalence to 4, whereas the other members can expand their covalence because of the presence of the d orbital. And the carbon also has a unique ability to form p pi multiple bond, p pi multiple bond with itself and with the other atoms also, that is other atoms of the small size and the high electronegativity. Example like carbon double bond, carbon double bond, carbon triple bond, then carbon double bond oxygen, carbon double bond sulfur, carbon triple bond nitrogen, like this. So usually the heavier element do not form the p pi bonds because their atomic orbitals are too large and diffuse the effective overlapping. And usually the carbon, already we are studied, that is they have a catenation properties. The catenation and the p pi bond formation, and they show allotropes of form. See the allotropes of carbon. What is the allotropes of carbon? So allotropes of carbon, the carbon exists many allotropic form, both crystalline as well as the amorphous substance. So diamond and graphites are the well known compound, and another one form is, that is called fullerene. Okay, first allotrope of carbon is diamond, then graphite and fullerene. First we'll see diamond. The diamond is a crystalline lattice, that is a diamond. Each carbon atom undergoes the sp3 hybridized and linked to 4 other carbon atoms by using the hybridized orbitals in the tetrahedral geometrical. So the carbon-carbon bond length is 154 picometer, and the structure extends the space and produce a rigid 3D, three-dimensional networks of the carbon atom. See, you can see in a textbook, that is how the diamond, how the graphite structure and how the fullerene structure. You can see your textbook that is given. See, it is very difficult to break. That is, diamond is a very hard, because it is difficult to break because of the covalent bond. That is, diamond is the hardest substance on the earth. It is used as an abrasive for the sharpening hard tools. So it is making dyes, and it the manufactures of tungsten filament for the electric light bulbs. Okay, so that is the uses of the diamond. Next is a graphite. So graphite has layered structure, that's mean like this layer form like this. You can see the structure in your textbook. See, the layers are held by the weak van der Waals forces. That's mean the distance of two layers between these two layers for 340 picometer. So each layer is composed of a planar hexagonal rings of the carbon atoms, that is carbon-carbon single bond. Within the layer is 141.5 picometer. So each carbon atom in the hexagonal ring undergoes to sp2 hybridization and makes 3 sigma bonds with 3 neighboring carbon atoms. Okay, fourth electron forms a pi bond. Then the electrons are delocalized over the hole shell. So electrons are mobile, and therefore the graphite conduct electricity along the sheet. Okay, so here graphite is conduct electricity. Next is fullerene. Third is fullerene. The fullerenes are made the heating of a graphite in an electric arc in the presence of the inert gas such as helium or argon. Can use it helium or argon. The sooty material formed with the condensation of vaporized CN. That is number of this. That is number. That means N indicates number. That is number of molecules. The small molecules consist mainly carbon 60 with the quantity of carbon 70, and traces of fullerene consisting of even number of carbon atoms up to 350 or above. The fullerenes are the only pure form of carbon because they have smooth structure without having dangling bonds. So fullerenes are gauge like molecules, like C60 molecule has a shape like a football, that is a soccer ball, or a called Buckminster fullerene, look like a football. Then it contains 26 member ring and 12 5 member ring. That is 26 member ring and 12 5 member ring. So 12 5 member ring. The 6 member ring is fused with 6 or 5 member rings, but a 5 member ring can only fuse with 6 member rings. Okay, all the carbon atoms are equal to their undergo sp2 hybridization. Each carbon atoms form 3 sigma bond with other 3 carbon atoms. Okay, then the remaining electrons at each carbon atom is delocalized in the molecular orbital, which in turn gives aromatic character to the molecule. So this ball shaped molecule has 60 varieties, and each one is occupied by one carbon atom, and it also contains both single and the double bonds with carbon-carbon single bond distance of 143.5 picometer and 138.3 picometer. Okay. Single bond, carbon-carbon single bond, and the carbon-carbon double bond distance. Okay, next is uses of carbon. The graphite fibers embedded in the plastic materials form high strength lightweight composites, and the composites are used in the products of, like in tennis racket, fishing rods, aircraft, like this. Okay, so graphite used to electrodes in batteries, then electrolysis, industrial electrolysis, like this. Then dilute alkalis, dilute acid, used to absorbing poisonous gases, like this. Okay, then some important compounds of carbon and silicon we will see. Here the some important compounds of carbon and silicon. That first we will see the oxides of carbon. The oxides of carbon, first preparation of carbon monoxide. Here the oxides of carbon, what is it? Here carbon monoxide and that carbon dioxide, two oxides are oxides of carbons are there. First we will see the carbon monoxide. The preparation of carbon monoxide is the direct oxidation of carbon in limited supply of oxygen or air. It gives carbon monoxide on a small scale. The pure carbon monoxide is prepared by the dehydration of the formic acid with concentrated sulfuric acid at 373 Kelvin temperature. You will get carbon monoxide. Then on commercial scale, this is on commercial scale, is prepared by the passing of steam over hot coke. The mixture of carbon monoxide and hydrogen gas is called water gas or syngas. Then when air is used to, instead of steam, a mixture of carbon monoxide and the nitrogen is produced. Here the carbon monoxide and nitrogen is produced, which is called producer gas. So carbon monoxide with hydrogen is water gas or synthesis gas. Carbon monoxide and nitrogen, there is mixture of carbon monoxide and nitrogen is producer gas. Here the water gas and producer gas are very important industrial fuels. The carbon monoxide is water gas or producer gas, can undergo a further combination forming carbon dioxide with the liberation of heat. Then carbon monoxide is a colorless, odorless and almost water insoluble gas. So it is a powerful reducing agent and reduces almost all metal oxides other than those of the alkali and the alkaline earth metals. Then the aluminium and the few transition metals also. Then this properties of the carbon monoxide used in the extraction of many metals from their oxide floor like this. So from the iron oxide, using of reducing agent carbon monoxide, you will get a pure iron. For zinc oxide, using of reducing agent of carbon monoxide, you will get the pure zinc. Then the carbon monoxide molecule are the 1 sigma and 2 pi bonds like this. One sigma and two pi bonds between the carbon and the oxygen atom. Because of the presence of lone pair of the carbon, carbon, then carbon monoxide molecule act as a donor and reacts with certain metal when heated to form metal carbonyl. The highly poisonous nature of the carbon monoxide arises because of its ability to form a complex with the hemoglobin, okay, which is about 300 times more stable than the oxygen hemoglobin complex. So this prevents the hemoglobin, the red blood corpuscle forms carrying oxygen around the body and ultimately resulting in the death. Then carbon dioxide. Dioxide is prepared by the complete combustion of carbon and the carbon containing fuels in excess of air, you will get the carbon dioxide. So methane and the presence of oxygen on heating, you will get the carbon dioxide and water molecule. In the laboratory preparation, there is a conveniently prepared by the action of the dilute HCl and the calcium carbonate, you will get the calcium chloride and the carbon dioxide gas. Then on the commercial scale, it is obtained by the heating limestone. There is a colorless and the odorless gas. It has low solubility in water, makes the immense biochemical and the geochemical importance. So with the water, it forms the carbonic acid. Then the carbonic acid, which is weak dibasic acid, and dissociates in the two step. The first step, the carbonic acid react with water to form the HCO3 minus and the hydronium ion. Again, the second step, the HCO3 minus react with water to form the carbonate and the hydronium ion. So here the carbonic acid and H2CO3 and HCO3 minus, this buffer system helps to the maintain the pH of the blood between the 7.26 to 7.42. That is, being in acidic nature, it combines with all alkalis to form metal carbonates. Then the carbon dioxide, which is normally present in the extent of 0.03% by volume in the atmosphere, it is removed from by the process of called photosynthesis. So it is the process which by green plants converts to atmospheric carbon dioxide into carbohydrates such as glucose. So the overall chemical changes like this. The carbon dioxide react with water and the photochemical reaction, photosynthesis, in the presence of chlorophyll, you will get glucose. So the by this process, plants make food for themselves as well as for animal and human beings. So unlike carbon monoxide, it is not poisonous, but the increase in combustion of fossil fuel and the decomposition of the limestone for the cement. Then the manufacturers in recent years seems to increase the carbon dioxide content of the atmosphere. This may lead to the increase in the greenhouse effect and thus rise the temperature of the atmosphere, which might have serious consequences. Okay? Usually the carbon dioxide can obtain the as a solid form is called dry ice. Okay, that is liquefied carbon dioxide to expand rapidly. That is, this is called dry ice. Then the carbon dioxide have the resonant structure like this. So this is the possible resonant structure. Next is silicon dioxide. See, the silicon dioxide, the formula is SiO2, plus 95% of earth crust made up of the silica and silicates. So silicon dioxide is commonly known as silica. They are occurs in several crystallographic forms, that is quartz, cristobalite and tridymite, that is some ores, right? So they are interconvertible at suitable temperature. The silicon dioxide is a covalent and they have a three-dimensional network solid in which each silicon and atom is covalently bonded the tetrahedral manner to the four oxygen atom. So like this. So each oxygen atom in terms covalently bonded to another silicon atom like this. So the each corner is shared with another tetrahedron like this. The entire crystal may be considered as a GN molecule in which 8 member rings are formed with the alternate silicon and oxygen atom like this. It is a 3D arrangement structure of silicon dioxide. Silica is a normal form, is almost non-reactive because of very high SiO bond, that is silicon oxygen bond enthalpy. It is resist to attack the attack by halogens, dihydrogen and most of the acid and metals even at elevated temperature. However, attacked by the sodium hydroxide and the hydrogen fluoride to form sodium silicate and silicon tetrafluoride. So this quartz is extensively used in the piezoelectric material. It has made possible to develop the extremely accurate clocks, modern radio and the television broadcasting and the mobile radio communications like this. So silica gel is used as a drying agent and a support for chromatographic materials, and the catalysis of Kiesler and amorphous form of the silica is used as the filtration of the plants. Next is the silicone. So silicon is an organosilicon polymer which have R2SiO, simply organosilicon polymer. It is a repeating unit. So the starting material for the manufacturers of the silicones are alkyl or aryl substituted silicones, chlorides. Here, suppose you are using any the alkyl or aryl group. The R indicate alkyl or aryl group. Then when methyl react with the methyl chlorides, to form silicon, then presence of copper as a catalyst, temperature like this. So methyl chloride, the methyl chloride react with the silicon, the presence of copper powder to form in the at 570 Kelvin, 573 Kelvin temperature, or 570 whatever it is, 573 Kelvin temperature. Here to form that, this is the methyl silicon chloride with a small amount of, again, adding of that methyl silicons are formed. That is the hydrolysis of then dimethyl dichloro. This is the dimethyl dichlorosilicane is formed. Then followed by the condensation of the polymerization yields straight chain polymer. So this is called silicone. So the chain length of the polymer can be controlled by adding of the CH3 thrice SiCl molecules, blocks are N. So we can see that. So now the chain length of the polymer can be controlled by adding of the SiCl three times, that is CH3 thrice SiCl which block the ends. Okay, so this is called silicon. Okay, next is silicates. So silicates, a large number of mineral exist in nature. Some of the examples are feldspar, zeolite, mica, asbestos, like this. So the basic structural unit of the silicate is SiO4-. So simply we can write it that the silicate So this is the tetrahedral structure of the SiO4-. Then usually we can representation that SiO4, that is Si, simply we can write Si. This is silicon. This joined with oxygen like this. So simply we can write like this. This O indicate oxygen, this O dot indicates silicon. Okay. Then zeolite. The zeolite is aluminum atoms of replaced by few silicon atoms in three-dimensional network of silicon dioxide. That overall structure is called alumino silicates. They have a negative charge, the cation such as like sodium ion, potassium ion, calcium or calcium 2+ ion, so balance the negative charges. Examples zeolites. Okay, zeolites are widely used in the catalyst in the petrochemical industries. Okay, thank you, students.